From News 8 WMTW-TV, this is a News 8 Now update.
You're watching News 8 Now. I'm Shannon Moss.
And I'm Erin O'Valley. After 16 years on the run, Boston crime boss Whitey Bulger is now in custody.
The FBI arrested him near Los Angeles last night with his girlfriend, Catherine Grieg. FBI had been conducting surveillance operations in the area. The 81-year-old Boston crime boss is a suspect in connection to 19 murders, including racketeering charges. Just last week, the FBI released a new public service announcement targeting Bulger's girlfriend. That PSA, in fact, was produced by a company right here in Portland. FBI in Boston says the publicity led to a tip, which then helped them find Bulger. Both he and his girlfriend are expected in court today.
Lawyers for convicted killer Jason Tortis will be back in court in July as they work to get him a second trial. Tortis was convicted of killing his former fiance, Kelly Gorham, back in 2007. Well, he was back in front of a York County judge yesterday. Tortis is asking for a new trial after his attorneys claim an alternate suspect was not explored during the original trial. 2 months ago, Tortis's attorneys produced several witnesses who testified that the victim's landlord, John Durfee, knew things that he shouldn't have known about that murder. Prosecutors claim the evidence against Tortis is overwhelming and a new trial would not change that conviction.
John Durfee dealing with his own legal issues.
Last October, he was arrested on drug charges after a chase on the main turnpike. News 8's Tim Ponton now has more on this.
John Durfee was last in court back in March when a judge revoked his bail on drug charges. Now, Maine drug agents picked up the 67-year-old Durfee and his wife, Nancy, after agents say they found PCP in their vehicle during a stop on the Maine Turnpike in Kittery. Now, John Durfee was previously arrested back in October of 2010 for leading police on a car chase. Durfee led police on that chase after Elliott police went to ask him a few questions about how his wife ended up along the side of the road semi-conscious. Now, police believe Durfee was driving the vehicle seen leaving the scene where his wife was found. However, his wife Nancy disputes that and says she gave a homeless man a ride and then had second thoughts and she asked him to let her out of the vehicle. She says she doesn't remember how she became unconscious. Now, John Durfee is scheduled to be here in court later this morning at 9 a.m. and we will keep you updated on this story on our website, WMTW.com, and later today on News 8. For now, from Alford at the York County Courthouse, I'm Tama Ponton, News 8 Now.
An outstanding group of graduates celebrating more than just a high school diploma.
And they have a lot to celebrate about. They're recipients of a free education and much more, all thanks to USM's Pioneers program. Students come from all over the state, and this week they have orientation on the university's campuses. The Pioneer program awards the top 8 students who majored in science, technology, education, and math free tuition to USM for 4 years, plus a computer and paid internships.
Definitely, because I think all of us, we're planning to go to college and money's always an issue, so it's just great to have that off your back and be able to just focus on your schoolwork.
It was unreal to get that scholarship. Yeah, no student loans, it's great. Yeah, I can't complain at all.
Great program. Well, thanks for tuning into this News 8 Now update. I'm Erin O'Valley.
And I'm Shannon Moss. Stay with us. Your forecast and sports highlights coming right up.